And we are here with the only one, the lovely Sophia Mai. So nice talking to you. And let me say, the episode you are playing in, I think it was season 2, episode 7, yeah, Girl in the Fireplace, was one of my absolute favorites because it's so humbling, it's so touching, and I watched it, I think, 2 weeks ago for the maybe fourth time.
Really?
And I still need to cry.
If I can make a grown man cry, then I'm really happy.
Yeah, you did it. So how emotional was the shooting for you? So was it still emotional, or was it just hard work?
Do you know what I remember? It was lovely work. It was just a pleasure to make. But I do remember when I read the letter, you know, the letter that he gets at the end from her, that she's written knowing that she's never going to see him again. It was just so beautifully written that I actually did naturally start, you know, tearing up when I read it. I think that's such a beautiful moment. I think is he by the window and he's reading it? Or she's already died and he reads that letter. That, for me, that really struck my heart.
And it's also amazing seeing so many people, Doctor Who fans, dressing up like Madame de Pompadour, because it's also a well-loved cosplay.
Is it? I haven't actually seen any.
I've seen maybe on conventions, I think, 4 times girls dressed up
really?
like Madame
Do
de Pompadour.
Do you know that dress, the kind of infamous dress, was actually Helen Mirren used that in a movie called, what was it, The Madness of King George, I think.
Okay.
So it was her dress before I wore it. Yeah.
So how amazing is it wearing a dress that Oscar winner Helen Mirren has worn?
Well, hopefully it will give me good vibes for the future. You never know.
Okay. And this is your first time in Germany so far?
No, goodness, okay. No. I've been to Germany loads of times. I love Germany. I studied German for A-level at school. Yeah, no, it's my favourite language. Of all of the European languages, I feel like, for me, the sound, the tone, the kind of the pace of your language is just, I love how sort of clipped it is. You know, it's really structured and I love it. I love German.
So maybe we can talk a little bit German?
Oh, and ein bisschen, but I've forgotten so much. Like, I'm able to understand everything. Yeah. If you were to speak to me in German, I could understand.
Wie geht's dir?
Gut, danke. Sehr gut.
Wie ist es für dich, wieder hier zu sein in Deutschland? Was, mit welchen Gefühlen kommst du hier hin?
What films have I seen?
Gefühlen. What kind of feelings when you're back here?
Oh, gosh. Well, I just feel, I don't know, I'm just really happy to be here. You know, I didn't realise, I wasn't really a Doctor Who fan prior to making my episode, but what I find amazing is that coming to a convention, you realise how like timeless the entire series is, and the fact that I'll be able to come to these conventions for years to come and people will still carry that story in their heart, you know, that it means a lot, you know.
And during the shooting of the episode, do you remember maybe some funny memories, maybe some nice things that happened behind the screens?
I remember tripping over that dress like a million times. I think there's outtakes that you can see on television, but it was so big and, you know, I'd kind of go up to him and be trying to kind of grab his tie to kiss him and I just fall flat on my face. So, yeah, I fell over loads of times.
Okay. When you see such an episode, or when you see this episode for the first time on screen, because you know how it was made, you know all the production details, when you see it on screen, is it also emotional for you? Or is it not emotional because you know how it was made? Or?
Well, I think for me, because it was, you know, I went on a different journey, you know, when I was telling the story, I wasn't in the audience at the time when I was telling it, so I had that experience of being the storyteller, but now for me, years gone by, I'm able to watch it and not be, and to be very objective, you know, or what's the word? Is that right? Subjective, objective? I'm confused. What I mean is that I can now sit back and watch it as an audience member as well. So that's, you know what I mean? That's really special that I can do that now. But watching it for me now is very different from how I felt then. It's timeless, that story, because it's about love. Love that can never be because one person ages and the other doesn't.
And you are here at Timeless in Kassel, which is for me is the best Doctor Who convention in
is
the whole world.
In the world, ever.
So how important is it for you being here and sharing the love with the fans in Germany?
Well, I mean, it's just lovely to share love in general. You know, that's what makes the world go round happily. And that's, I think, why as human beings we're meant to be here, is to kind of share love. So, yeah, it's great to be here.
If you would have a TARDIS in real life, where would you go? You can choose everything in space and time.
Oh my god, and like
beyond millions of stars and galaxies.
I would go back to when God decided to create this whole thing and figure out what was going on in his mind and kind of be there with him watching. Right, to the beginning. the beginning of everything. That's where I'd go.
Okay. And my last question, did you have maybe a favorite Doctor Who line? Is there anything...
A favorite
line from Doctor Who?
Oh, I think when I say Doctor, Doctor Who, that one. You remember?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Can you say it again for me in the camera?
Doctor. Doctor Who.
Amazing. Thanks so much. All right.